Press is the founder of Be Straw Free, I think is the name of the website. Milo, come up and give us a chat.
It's that simple. The server brings the drinks to the table, and and says in a very friendly voice, "Would anyone like a straw with that?" And anyone who wants a straw gets one. By the way, restaurants that are participating love this project. Most green initiatives cost money up front, but my project saves restaurants money from the first day they start offering straws, instead of putting one into every drink automatically. That brings up a really important point. One of the best things about this offer first idea is that each one of you can customize it to fit your own restaurants. Some restaurants enthusiastically advertise their switch to offering straws first, and others prefer to quietly make the small, subtle change. There are also restaurants, for example, that adopt the offer first policy in their dining room, but prefer not to implement it in their bar or lounge. This is not a one-size-fits-all idea. Any restaurant can reduce the number of straws they use by adjusting the offer first concept so it fits their own business. But of course, the more you use the offer first policy, the more money you save and fewer straws that wind up in landfills. In fact, participating restaurants have reported back to me that they cut back 50 to 80% on the number of straws they use since they started offering first. This means that everyone who wants a straw gets one, but that 50 to 80% of their customers choose not to take a straw when offered. This means more customers are happy, fewer busloads of straws are headed for landfills, and the restaurants save money. So here we are again, back at People, Planet, and Profit. So by simply offering straws instead of putting one into every drink automatically, restaurants save money, their quality of service is still just as good, and it's good for the environment. And as we all know, good for the environment is good PR. There are several great ways to cut down on the number of disposable plastic we pile into landfills. Mr. McCarroll from Ted's Montana Grill has suggested a really good one, switching from plastic to paper straws, which can be composted in most places. Speaking of using different kinds of straws, at first I thought it would be a good idea to ask restaurants to consider simply switching to biodegradable or compostable plastic straws. But here's the problem, at least for right now, with using straws that are made of biodegradable or compostable plastic. As you know, biodegradable and compostable plastics only biodegrade or compost under very specific conditions. Some waste management facilities in the US are able to process most kinds of plastic, but for various reasons, which we can get into later if you're interested, almost none of these facilities can process any kind of plastic straws at this time. So for now, most waste management facilities across the nation have to send all the various kinds of plastic straws they receive off to landfills, even the biodegradable and compostable ones. As you may also know, for environmental safety reasons, landfills are designed not to allow the contents to biodegrade or compost readily. So most of these well-intentioned and usually more expensive biodegradable and compostable plastic straws, unfortunately, are piling up in landfills where they will not biodegrade or compost efficiently. They lie there right alongside the disposable straws they're supposed to replace, and they simply become expensive trash. So using biodegradable or compostable plastic straws is only an advantage when and if those straws end up in a facility that can process them effectively. But actually, the more I thought about it, the more I realized that landfills are probably the best place for any disposable plastic straws, or for any plastic straws, period, that aren't being processed by waste management facilities. Otherwise, they wind up as litter on our countrysides, floating in our rivers, lakes, and even out in those huge plastic islands that we're all hearing about that are building up in our oceans. We can do something here on Earth, somewhere on our Earth, even when my own grandchildren are born. Actually, far longer than that. It's time to reduce, reuse, and rethink our plastic. In fact, we need to think reduce, 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 instead of recycle, recycle, recycle. Here's the thing. This planet's not a place that your kids and I will inherit at some point far off in the distant future. This is our planet, too. We live here right now. There's a great bumper sticker that really motivates me, which says, the best way to predict the future is to help create it. You and I, adults and kids, can create the future for our planet. The goal of my project is for it to become standard for restaurants nationwide to offer straws to customers instead of putting one into every drink automatically. Similar to the way it became standard a few years ago for grocery stores to offer shoppers the choice between paper or plastic bags. But I cannot achieve my goal without your help. That's why it's so important to me to get the chance to talk to you today. I'm asking you to help me work myself out of a job.
Small ways, and it's really gratifying. Thank you guys so much for sharing. We do have Milo. We have a gift for you. It's a contribution to the North Texas Food Bank, and George the same. And we thank you so much. Your story is wonderful. George, I just want to say to you, I've known you for so many years, and it is a pleasure to see what you're doing and the leadership you're taking for the end of it. Thank you very much. Thank you, Milo. All right, thank you so much.